thought it's got a labyrinth with a pulse cannon right in the back.
You can't write it. You can't write it. You can't write it. Silence!
I kill you!
Allah!
Yeah, I'm here. Sorry. Yeah. Hold on. Alright, go ahead. I'm here. I'm confused. Did you have a question? Burst? Your thing goes off, so you're saying like your radar for like cheating, is that what you're saying? Because my burst rate's fast.
Can't write
alrighty
it. Cannot write it.
Well, I don't know.
Fucking hell. I'd hear a bone from this kid.
Me?
You're the shit.
Johan, do you get really bad hangovers?
Hey Spurs, what gun would you like me to use? The guy who you just said his burst rate is blah, 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 blah. That's what you basically said. All right. Well, I don't know what to say. Chalk another one up to who thinks I mod, which is like in the double digits now. No, I'm not here. I'm only talking in your imagination. Mm-hmm. All that practice from finger banging, man. Why is there no way? Here. Let me put my... I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll put my mic next to my fucking trigger finger. And then you can hear it. How about that? Would that be okay? Yeah, man, that's me. You got me, Spurs. You fucking got it. Yeah, no, me. Ramble. Oh my god, this dude's he's wasted right now. No, he was talking to me. He said ramble.
Yate!
Mr. Spurs, you got a chaperone up here?
Jesus, I can't listen to this fucking idiot talk anymore. Teabags. I guess ion torpedo and ion grenade for this map's not necessary. Depends. What the heck? Man, alive. Get in here, people. Go. Dude, they're all in this hall. Oh my god, where's Chewie? Just shoot down the hall. You'll get a lot of kills. Or assists. Oh my god. Oh, there's Greedo coming. Getting absolutely destroyed. And I got him.
Okay, here we go. Activate see that? Signal the Y-wing. Jetpack, personal shield, Bacta, and bodyguard is my trait. Keep control of the and I've got the DLT 19. Okay? My strike pack has an anti-recoil feature. Okay, to it. It's turned on right now. Okay? Watch when I fire. You ready? With the DLT 19. See that? Look at it. It moves around, right? See that? That's without aiming. I'm not pressing the L2, okay? That's hip fire, okay? With anti-recoil, okay? Now here's when you aim. Look at that. It even moves a little, right? And I have anti-recoil. Okay? That's what the DLT-19 does with anti-recoil. It's turned on. Okay? Look how much it moves. Okay? Now watch. I'm going to turn it off. This is the gun as it's supposed to be used without any mods. You ready? Here's hipfire. See that? That's hipfire. Without the strike pack anti-recoil turned on. That's how it's supposed to be shot. That's what it's supposed to move like. Okay? Now watch when I aim, when I press the L2. That's without the mod turned on. That's without the anti-recoil. Okay? Did you watch his gun? What it did in that video? Okay. His gun does not move at all. On Ramble's stream from New Year's, okay, he was using this gun without focus, and that thing didn't move 1 inch. 1 centimeter for you Europeans. 1 millimeter. Look at that. Look at that. That's with L2. That's aiming. Oh, shit. I gotta get out of here. Shield.
None of it's fake. None of it's fake. Did you know? Yeah, guys, what this really works, groups.
And she'll be like making money every single time. I don't know how she does it. Really good.
Is that who I think it is? Come here, young man. Uh-oh. Come on, I'm going after Labyrinth. Leave me alone. Mr. Shameless. I love it. Yeah.
We are taking command of the last control point.
I love it. We may have to switch up the teams though. This is pretty bad.
Yeah.
This is pretty bad.
Now I'm gonna change the blaster to the SE-14C. Okay. Here's another gun with notorious recoil. Okay. Here we go. Same hand.
Armor locking signal initialized.
Same hand, Ruby. Personal shield. Bacta and bodyguard with the SC-14. Okay, now let's watch the gun without the strike pack anti-recoil. Okay, this is how the gun is supposed to be shot in the game with just a normal controller. Ready? Here goes. See? Look at my reticle. It goes up. Now watch when I fire it fast. Look at.
Uplink station engaged.
You see that?
Well done.
Look at
now
the spread.
Defended.
Look how high it went up. Okay, that's me bursting. Okay, on hip fire. Now I'm gonna aim. Look at that. Okay, now I'm gonna try to keep the aim on target. Ready? That's me trying to keep it steady. You see how much it moves? That's normal. That's without the anti-recoil.
And she'll be like making money every single time. I don't know how she does it.
Okay, now I'm turning on anti-recoil. You ready?
Reactivate it.
Look at that. You see that? And I'm aiming. Look at it, I'm aiming. That's with anti-recoil. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Look how much it moves. Okay?
Yeah, guys, this really works. Yeah.
When you watch his video, and you watch him firing that SE-14C, the gun does not move 1 millimeter, 1 inch. Look at that. That's with the strike back on. That's with the anti-recoil and the strike back. Okay, that's turned on. Here's without it. Here's without, and I'm bursting R2. I'm having to move R2 and steady the R3. Try to stay on target. Look at that. What do you think? What's your thoughts on what you saw Ramble doing in his video, in his stream, and what I'm doing right now? Look at it. It doesn't move at all. It doesn't move at all. You're too polite. You won't say that the guy's cheating, but I'm not like you. I'll say that he's cheating. I'm saying that he's using an anti-recoil script with Cronus or Titan, because that thing does not move whatsoever. And here's the proof. This is the gun without my strike pack on, and I'm trying to steady the aim. You see how much recoil there is. And this gun right here, the SE-14C, is the most, it's probably got the most recoil of any gun. It's got so much spread. Huh? Good cop, bad cop. You're the good cop. I'm the bad cop. I gotta get out of here. They're gonna kill me. This guy's a cheater. He's a cheater, and the thing is that he spent time on his stream denying that he's cheating, because Spurs Johan is on the stream. You don't hear him talking, but in the stream, he's identified as the person accusing Ramble of cheating, right? And Ramble is making a big deal, a big stink about the fact that he doesn't cheat, right? So even a guy who's kind of like on their team, right, Spurs Johan, he's suspicious of Ramble, and he's telling him on his stream. Look at that. And they're probably friends. So, I mean, this guy, Ramble, he's over here. He's bitching and moaning about modders, okay? And that they're trash. And yet this guy, he's modding. That's what I'm saying. He's modding. But he's worse because he's lying about it. He's over here denying. He's turning blue. Denying that he's cheating, when in fact I think I've just proven that he's cheating with this demonstration. Look at that. That's with the anti-recoil of the strike pack. Look at that. Look how much recoil there is. Okay, that's without me steadying the R3. And here's me steadying the R3, trying to stay on target. Okay. Even with anti-recoil, this gun is recoiling. Some guns are better with the anti-recoil. I'll show you right now. I'll show you the E11.
Are you there?
Okay, and watch the 11 now, right? Here's a different gun. This is what the E11 looks like without naturally, right? How the gun is supposed to fire in the game. This is hip firing. Okay, look at that. See the spread? You see the spread? Look at that. That's the spread without aiming with the L2. Now here's aiming. Okay, it's a little bit better, but there's still spread, right? The gun starts off being accurate. It hits the first couple of shots, and then it starts getting out of control, right? When you aim with the L2, the first few shots are on target, and then it starts spreading. It starts going out of control. Now here's with the strike pack anti-recoil on, okay? Here's hip fire. Look at that. Look at that. That's with hip fire. You see that? Look at that. No spread, right? Okay, now watch what happens when I aim. L2. Absolutely no movement. See that? That's like Ramble. That's what Ramble's looks like on his stream. It looks like this. There's absolutely no movement. See that? Absolutely no movement. Okay? This is just to demonstrate, even though this is not the gun that he used in his stream, it's to demonstrate that I do have anti-recoil on this strike pack, okay? Sorry, buddy, but you've been caught red-handed.
Wiping my glasses here.
You wear glasses?
Gaming glasses.
What? What are those?
Look up Gunner gaming glasses.
Mm-hmm.
They, it's like, you know, like your, what are they called? Your illuminated lenses that block out the sun. These have special ones that, like special lenses that filter out blue light on the screen.
Yeah.
You know, and they're really good. I like them. But, yeah.
Oh, fuck, honey! Oh, shit! I gotta run. I gotta do the Ruby thing. Every time she does that to me, I have to run. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck, I'm dead. Oh, fuck!
You know... Stupid controller. Do you ever get stick drift? Like when your controller just looks by itself? You're trying to aim and it just moves around?
Yep.
The amount of money that I've spent on controllers, I could probably have a freaking $4,000 gaming PC. You know?
Bro, did you miss those last two kills? Those are like the best pulses that I've ever done.
Those are really good. You gotta go get another.
Oh,
there you go.
Shit. Nice. Are you watching this, Ruby?
Nice. Call you way good, bro.
Oh, shit. Oh, no, it's over. Oh, shit. I'm. Oh, fuck. I need a 19x kill, though.
You're like all juiced up. Oh, fuck.
I got you though.
There you go.
Oh shit. Shit, there he is. There he is. He's waiting for me. Oh fuck.
Actually, I need to. I'm not playing like I normally play.
Oh shit, I'm over. No! Oh, fuck. Oh,
I usually
God.
Play really, really aggressive.
Mm-hmm.
Even with this loadout.
Oh! Shit! I'm pretty happy with those two kills that
those
I got.
Those pulses were nice. Those were.
Oh, fuck.
Ooh, there's a 19x.
Oh, no!
Ooh, what was that?
I don't think this is really fair.
Well, I have been using this loadout for a while, so...
Fuck! Oh, fucking rail!
There you go.
I don't...
How, bro, I haven't hit you with one pulse cannon yet. I'm better at the 19x than the pulse cannon. It's ridiculous.
Shit.
Am
there,
I rubber
finally.
Banding on your screen? Because you're rubber banding on mine.
Maybe. Bro, Ruby is sending me laughing emojis. Okay, right
oh,
now.
Oh, I've seen that. Damn!
I'm gonna emote
way
you.
Good, are you sitting there talking and Waygood's yeah. playing? You got Waygood over there?
Maybe. Oh, shit.
Come here, boy.
Damn. I'm getting wasted. Fuck. Look at him. Look at him. Bye-bye.
Oh, my God. That is so embarrassing. I'm sitting there. Where'd he go? Oh, my God.
Oh, no. Shit. Damn. Well, unfortunately, I don't have one button rolling like Ramble. Oh, fuck. Why didn't you die? No. Son of a... I'm going to leave a little surprise for him, Ruby.
Are you down bottom again, or are you up top?
Watch. No, I'm going to be a camper, bro. Oh, shit.
Oh,
whoa, fuck.
That went through your head.
Good.
How?
I don't know, but...
That doesn't make sense.
I'm going to be real cheap with you.
God.
Where'd you go? There you are.
Are you kidding me? I pre-fired that, and that bullet literally went through your skull. Well, through your characters, anyway. My God, you are really trying.
I'm a tryhard right now.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, my God. I wish I could... Oh, fuck, I fell off the map. Oh, I'm dead. I'm dead. Oh!
Oh, my God, I can't believe it.
Well, I think I acquitted myself. I'm not total trash with this thing. Oh, look,
no.
I got most kill assists.
You should, I mean, you were hitting really good accurate shots.
No, I don't usually play with the pulse, man. You know, Ruby and I will do some 1v1s here on Hangar. And
yeah.
I'll use the pulse sometimes, right? Especially if I use the bow staff. I'll use the pulse. So that's about the only practice I get on it. You know,
well,
back
you
in,
were hitting some pretty advanced shots there.
It was just pure luck, bro.
Pure luck. Something. You should do that on freaking pubs a little more.
We're gonna do it today, bro. We're gonna do it today. All right. Special needs and Tecosa, man. We had them in the Art Wayne video.
They're partied up.
Yeah. Oh, nice sniping vehicle. Oh, kill special needs, bro. Special needs and
yeah,
and
he's Lando just hiding somewhere. See, like, that's what I hate is guys like that get on this game every day and all they use is bodyguard. It's the only thing they use. It's so fucking annoying.
Well, you've just described like almost everybody.
I know.
Playing
I
the
mean,
game
it's,
regularly.
It's, I mean, everyone. That is the number one thing that's killing the game is these good players that are seasoned. You know, they know what they're doing, and they get on every day and use E3 and back to guard. Mm-hmm. And casual players that get home after work just can't compete with, you know, anything mm-hmm. like that.
And then you add to the mix that they all get on the same team. They're partied up, and they're all on the same team. They're spawning off of each other. They don't have to run back to the action. They're already in the mix because their partner's still alive.
For sure.
Okay, I'm coming in. Lab the sniper. Fuck, this is going to be weird. Okay, there's another guy above me. Fuck. Tekosin. You again. Fuck me.
Here's the call, son.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I just hit him.
I got stuck. This guy
oh,
is not
I'm overheating. What the fuck? Oh, shit. Tony Fernandez, the guy you thought I am. Fuck me. Oh, bye-bye. Oh, my God. You didn't die. It was almost
yeah,
a headshot.
You gotta aim for the head for most of them.
Mm-hmm.
I aim for the head a lot, but if they're not using bodyguard, I shine with this class the most at medium range. Long range, you're always gonna get hit markers. Mm-hmm. Mastering it at medium range, you'll usually one shot them. So like what I crave the most in gaming.
Yeah.
It seems like I can't always just like be on point and play how I want all the time, but what I love is when get in the zone.
Yeah.
To where you play for so long and then like you just get in the zone.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, finally.
Fucking Tony.
Fuck, dude. Cannot hit anybody. Fucking gun.
Yeah, and they got an 8 dog. I'm friends with him. He's a super good objective player.
Oh my god. Your friend, he didn't die, dude. Point blank range.
No, I headshot him for 100. There. There we go.
Him. Oh, fuck me. Jesus. Bro, how come the pulse does not land where your reticle?
Oh my god.
What is it that I'm doing
yeah,
wrong?
That's what I'm saying. That goes for almost every gun in this game. It's like, at one point when I do the best in this game, it's when I just like trust my instincts. And centering the screen is weird, you know? It's like, you just have to almost play with no HUD, because I know what you're saying. Even with the pulse and with other guns, your crosshairs can be completely away. Like in one of my videos, my 19X,
yeah.
The crosshairs are legit 2 feet to the side from
yeah.
this guy.
Yeah.
And he's like 8 feet in front of me, but somehow that's how it's designed.
Bye-bye. But, I keep killing this guy Claude, man. Okay, I got it. Oh, fuck. Special needs. You again. Okay, I'm gonna go get him.
They got so many objective players. These are like some of the best walker assault objective players. We gotta go up top. LaSalle and an 8 dog, they can win a game on their own. They are just ninjas.
Mm-hmm.
Ridiculous. They're super good. They know what they're doing.
Finally. Got his partner.
Got
okay.
him.
Alright, nice. Oh, got the other
nice.
Guy.
No, he got it?
Somebody did, but I'm deactivating. Or activating.
Activating.
Tells you how much I know about Walker. Okay, somebody's underneath us. You got him?
Yeah, it's an 8 dog. No, he's full health. He's coming up.
Okay, I'm gonna try to get this hero.
Wait, the you left. Said you got the hero?
Yeah, I got Luke.
B9 them. B9 them, drop your orbital on.
Oh, no. No, I already got Luke, bro. I'm just gonna try to clear out these. Okay. Incoming hostiles.
No, what the fuck?
Oh my god, fucking lag.
Nice. Fuck these guys. We won?
Look at this guy. Special needs.
Gotta try so hard. The bodyguard is so goddamn annoying.
I got his ass.
You pulsed him.
I pulsed him.
Nice.
Here comes his buddy. Hold on. Look at him. He's running with his bitch bubble. Look at him.
Nice.
Ooh. Oh, fuck.
Pulsum.
Watch out behind. Oh, rolling in place. God damn. Get him, bro.
Come on,
get this
jump.
Guy. Get this guy. Nice. Back.
I don't know, there's someone back here. Yeah.
Yeah, let me go get his ass.
He's in the cave.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, it's special needs, bro.
I paused him. I got him to, like, one health.
Oh, he's getting teabagged, too. Oh. By some guy named Kyle. Come here, Tikozan. Where are you, buddy? Look at him.
Fucking bitch.
Bye-bye. Fuck. Right there, he's right in front of you. Special needs. Oh, fuck. Oh, my God. Help me kill these two bastards, bro.
Using their bullshit bodyguard hands. I gotta have it every game. I swear these guys use it in a fucking skirmish. And I just blanked them with the pulse cannon. That's really cool.
I keep running into these guys doing this thing. I ran into them with Wayne when I was using 84 sensitivity, bro. I couldn't kill them. Oh my god.
We gotta do the objective here.
We do?
Ooh. Yeah, it'd be nice to win two in a row against them.
Look, they're both coming. Oh shit. Look at them. Oh shit. Look at them.
These guys are the absolute scum of Battlefront. E3, back to guard every day, trying to prove their dominance or something freaking stupid like that.
Jesus, okay, fine.
Alright, we gotta keep the speeders off, but they still might be able to just shoot them down. Alright, we gotta get them off the dish. There's a dish in the back.
Mm-hmm. Fuck.
Oh, they can probably still shoot them. I don't know who their hero is.
Bro, 10 and 19. You really thought we were gonna win that match? With me on the 19X?
We could've. I mean, you don't have to use the 19X, but...
No, I'll try to help you, bro. I'll try to help you more. Special needs to close them. Okay. Alright, guys. They haven't seen me yet with my normal loadout.
Yeah.
I've always encountered them filming for this show. That cheat codes?
No, it's needs.
Got him. And he got teabagged for the show. There's a bunch on the left. Okay, Darth Gator. Okay, got that guy.
Come on, quit rolling in place, you stupid piece of shit.
Bunch of them, dude. Okay, they're coming. Who wants me? Who wants me? Come get me. Come get me. Look at him. Look at this guy. What a puss. What a puss. What's up, T-Cosin? What's up, little bitch? You thought that was the real Labyrinth you were fucking playing against? Oh, you fucking bitch. Hmm? You guys think you're playing against the real Labyrinth, huh?
Look at this guy. God, he pops his fucking bubble if you look at him.
Yeah. What's up, T-Cosin? What's up, buddy? That's for the video. What the fuck? Fuck you think you're going? Oh my god. Unbelievable.
What?
Oh, you lucky son of a bitch. You'll see in the video. Saved your ass, bro.
Yeah, you did.
Oh, fuck. Nice bomb. You got it, bro.
Destroy that walker. We're almost there.
Yep. Nice. Nice, bro. Nice.
Fucking douchebags.
They got wrecked.
Get on every fucking day and use the same thing.
Nice job, bro.
Such a piece of shit.
Who? Which guy?
Special.
Oh, yeah.
He's like your buddy Subsided. He's gotta always mod no matter who he fucking plays against. He could be in a skirmish lobby by himself and he's gotta have his mods on.
Oh, so you think Subsided mods?
He does.
Yeah.
He thinks. I know he does. It's obvious, man.
What are the obvious things for you?
Well, the rate of fire on the burst and consistency, it never skips, ever. Mm-hmm. You know? Yeah, that's for sure.
I asked him to burst his EE3 and EE4. And he didn't look like he had rapid fire to me. Like, he was bursting it.
Nah, you can't burst that long and stay accurate like that.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, for weeks on end, months on end, playing every day like that, shooting through the air smooth, you know,
Mm-hmm. Welcome to another episode of Tales of Battlefront. We got Mr. OG-PEEPS, a.k.a. mypeeperhurts. I know you as mypeeperhurts.
Yep, that was my original.
What's up, bro? How you doing today?
Good.
Are you getting wrecked?
Going against modders.
Now you're doing pretty good, though.
Yeah, so far. Doing all right.
But yeah, the team you're up against, man, they're stacked.
And I'm using triple snipe, and these guys get on every single day and use back to guard in E3. That's all they use.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah, bro. Try harder. Appreciate you doing this show, man. You know, here on Tales of Battlefront, we're trying to talk to as many notable players in this game, dude, that we can. And, you know, it's really like a type of history, man, of this game. You know, we're trying to
Oh, yeah.
We're trying to get everybody's all of the different characters and different players that have played this game for the last 5 years. We're just trying to understand them a little bit more, you know, than what we're used to. So I appreciate it, man. I appreciate you doing this with us today. Ruby is not going to join us today. Her mic jacked up. So anyways, it'll be you and me only. What's your loadout today?
Triple snipe, and been using the purple dragon loadout a little bit. The TL-50 with the back to guard, mm-hmm. you know, shield and back to bomb and jetpack.
Purple dragon. I thought he ran with the DH-17. I guess he does use that.
The only thing I've ever seen him play with is the TL-50.
Does he use the glitched out version? The secondary fire glitch of the TL-50. I hope he's not using it.
The only way you can do that is with, like, the hero or with one of, like, the honor guards or something.
No. There's a glitch for the TL-50 specifically. Watch, who's that kid that plays with Waygood? You know, the one with the really annoying voice? What's that guy's name?
Professor Bot.
That kid, sometimes I go on Waygood's stream.
Yeah.
And I'll hunt him down just to hear him. He's got a real distinctive voice, right? This guy. Yeah. Okay, I got the hero. Who should I be?
Be 9 on his orbital for the walker. Set that turret up on the lanes.
Oh my god. 9 dumb. I absolutely hate this guy.
Really?
Yeah. Well, you know, I'm a heroes player, bro.
He shines in Walker Assault.
I hear that. But not for me. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Let's see. Come here, Palpy. Show me your face, buddy.
Okay. There's some guys up top if you want to pulse them.
Yeah, I see him.
Got one.
Okay, got one.
You were talking about my stats, how I have all these kills with these different guns.
Yeah.
And it's true, like, you'll never see guys like Special Needs or Tikosin or anyone challenge themselves and get 100+ with the TL-50. Like, you see that last video I just did?
Yeah.
I got 104 kills with the TL-50.
Yeah.
You know, 100+ with the, I'll give you back, you know, with the DH-17 with different loadouts.
Yeah.
And these guys get on, you know, it's one thing that's annoying is they have the reaction times. They, you know, they have the gun skill.
Yeah.
And they still get on every day and use their fucking crybaby bullshit loadout.
Yeah. I got it right there.
You want to put it almost as close as you can to it, kind of, you know.
Yeah.
Good medium range so it locks on quick.
What's this guy? Okay. Oh, fuck. Trying to kill me. Okay, they're pushing to the right.
Just stay in cover behind that little head glitch there.
Mm-hmm. I got your buddy, an 8 dog.
Yeah, he's a really good objective player.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy good.
Mm-hmm. He's done. Look at this guy. An 8 dog. Look at him. Look at him.
What?
He's jumping to put vipers next to me. He pops the shield. Thank you. Okay, now where should I go? So I should lay some...
You should still be good right here.
Yeah? Okay. I know these guys are going to try to orbital me.
Oh, there's an 8 dog. He's coming.
Yeah, I know. Look at him.
Get ready to call your orbital in on one of them.
Yeah. Okay, let's see if that works. Okay. I hope I can land it.
Move!
Oh, fuck, bro.
There's a bat, though. Yeah, you should be able to get two orbitals off on it. With this mini, we'll probably take both of them down.
Guy's trying to shoot me. Move!
Yeah, we're gonna get both of them. Your orbital about ready again?
It's almost. But they're hitting me where I'm at. Come on. Shit, bro, it didn't go off.
What, did you call it in and it like glitched out and
yeah,
didn't work?
Yeah, it didn't work. And now this chicken's hunting me,
that's
dude.
That's annoying.
Fuck me.
Yeah, I hate that.
Fucking unbelievable. But I think we're still going to win.
Yeah, we got it.
Nice. Nice job.
Thanks.
Okay, bro. So, tell us, what is your gaming background, dude? How long you been playing?
Like, you talking first video game I ever played or just Battlefront?
Yeah. The first video game you ever played.
So, it's a toss-up. It was when I was really young. I mean, I'm saying, you know, toddler, 4 or 5 years old. It was either the Atari or the Sega. And I remember, I still got, you know, perfect video in my head. One of my favorite games was Judge Dredd on the Sega.
Yeah.
Do you remember an old Sega? They're like big in your hand, and you played it like a Game Boy.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, Judge Dredd on the Sega. And then from there, I had a Game Boy DS, I think. It was like a flip phone Game Boy. They were really popular when they came out
right.
for a couple of years. They were really cool. It was a Game Boy, and it flipped open. And
yeah.
they were just so freaking cool. You could stuff it in your pocket, you know, and
play
a lot of Mario on there. Then on PS2, once I was a little older, I grew up like probably from 9 to 12 years old playing PlayStation 2, and favorite games on there was MX versus ATV Unleashed.
Yeah.
And that was, there still isn't a game as good as that one to this day.
Oh,
and,
nice.
I grew up playing the original Battlefronts on there. Now, if there were statistics for those games and you could go back and look, I probably got, you know, 5,000 hours on the original Battlefront games. I would always go over to my buddy Tyler's house and we would play split screen, you know, he'd get off school.
Yeah.
And we'd go play instant action, you know, and Battlefront 1, Battlefront 2.
Yeah.
And, you know, and those games are just so much fun. They're so cool. When you jump with the heroes, they do an actual flip like in the movies. And I mean, we'd play instant action for like 5 hours, you know, every weekend for years on end. And
nice.
So, I mean, I've been playing Battlefront for as long as I can remember. And then when this one came out, it was quite the deal.
Now,
but then,
hold on.
A Nintendo, or
uh-huh.
yeah, go ahead.
No, go ahead, finish your thought.
And then I had a Nintendo Wii, it's at my buddy's house yet. But
right.
on there, played a lot of Mario, and I had a few different consoles.
Mm-hmm.
But one thing where I would say where I got my skill from, my reaction times, is when I got the PlayStation 3. And I had a little system on there, kind of like I do now on the PS4, to where I would play zombies on Black Ops and Black Ops 2. And that
yeah.
was kind of my chill, just play, have fun. But then Modern Warfare 2, I was kind of good at that. It was like really cool, and I'd get like an AC-130, you know?
Yeah.
But then when Modern Warfare 3 came out, that is where I ascended. That's where I learned how to figure a game out, the movement. You know, really, gaming is all about the movement. No matter which game you're playing,
yeah.
it's how you feel, how fast your character can move, how you, you know, just how you can do everything, how fast you can run up to the corner and look around it and just understand it. And long story short, what I'm getting to is, on Modern Warfare 3, I got so good on there to where I was getting double MOAB. So, you know, in Modern Warfare 2, if you got the tactical nuke, it ended the game. And that was a 25 kill streak, and that was really cool. I only got a couple on there. But on Modern Warfare 3, I got double MOABs in one game. And, you know, that's really good. That's 225 kill streaks in, yeah, you know, one game. And, you know, I hit trick shots on there. I even got a clip on my YouTube on Call of Duty World War 2 where I hit an online trick shot. And in the world of gaming and, you know, just being a nerd in general, that's pretty high up there on some of the things you can achieve in an right. online multiplayer game.
Listen, I didn't really play any games, dude, before Battlefront 2015. Like, I bought the PS3 to play Battlefield 3, right? And Black Ops.
Oh, really?
But I wasn't like, I was totally a casual player, you know? I just didn't put a lot of time into them. But I enjoyed it, right? But when Battlefront came out, because of the fact that I was a Star Wars fan, right? Like, I just really got into this game and played this game unlike any other game I had ever played before. And just started to put in hours, you know, over these last 5 years.
Yeah.
And you know, I started off as a first person perspective, you know, player. And I even started off Battlefront in first person. Did you play Battlefront in first person or third person from the get-go?
No, mainly third person from the get-go, but there is times where I'll put it in first person just, you know, for something different.
Mm-hmm.
And there is different shots that you're capable of making in first person.
Yeah.
So there's reasons I like first person for that,
right.
And in some ways you do play better in first person.
Mm-hmm. Like in which ways? Tell us.
It's like, how can you say it? When you're in first person, you just are more accurate. You know, if you're in the zone, you are. It's just weird. It's hard explaining.
Yeah.
But it has to do with your you can focus more, I feel like. You know, I mean, third person, yeah, you can do the shoulder peek and whatnot, mm-hmm. but they both have their benefits.
Bro, I see your loadout is your sniping loadout, yeah?
Yeah.
Are you doing the triple, the cycler,
yep.
DLT 19X, and pulse?
Yes.
No jetpack. Okay, I'm going to be kind of like your bodyguard, bro.
Oh my god, and I've rolled in place, and this guy just puts me down.
This guy? Got him lighting up. Oh shit.
Here,
gummy
get a
bear.
Spawn. But the point I was getting up to, though, talking about Modern Warfare 3 and reaction times, I was leading up to Battlefront. So when I was talking about how gaming's all movement, you understand the game, you learn it, you're like, okay, you know, yeah, I got this figured out.
Right.
When I started playing this game, I was like, oh yeah, Battlefront, and then I realized they're like, oh hey, you can be quick at this, like you can really, you know, do something here. That's what got me hooked, is the fact that this game can operate as fast as I can.
Right.
You know, so it's like, for instance, you know, Battlefront 2, the mechanics are a little more like Battlefield, and you can't just make those quick moves, quick shots like you can in Call of Duty and you can here.
Mm-hmm.
So I always told my friends, and you can ask them, you know, throughout the years I've been playing with them, I told them that if you're, you know, say you're holding the hard copy of this game in your hand, regardless of what it's called, if this game was Star Wars or not, whatever the name of it was, I would still play it just because of the way the mechanics are and the way you can move and fight and just the way you can do things. So right. I said, I would always play this game even if it had a different name, mm-hmm. because I recognized something about it and I really took to it.
Interesting, bro. This kind of analysis I've never done before, because I just don't have any experience with any other games, really.
Yeah.
When I went into Battlefront 2, one of the reasons I don't play it is because the mechanics are just so much different than this, and so I don't like it, you know? That's the bottom line.
Yeah.
What about for you? You like Battlefront 2?
Yeah, I play it. I've actually been playing it more recently. It's got its ups and downs, you know.
Mm-hmm.
All games do. All of them do.
Right.
You know, I do like the reinforcements in that game. They put some really cool reinforcements in, like the characters you can play as, you know, the side characters only cost a couple thousand. They call them the reinforcements.
Yeah.
And they're pretty cool, like the Ovidian Gunner and stuff. And my favorite class in that game is the support. I mean, the minigun is so good on that support. It's just fun to use. They really nailed that and did that one right.
Hey, so tell everybody, man, where are you from?
Grew up in North Dakota, right next to Canada.
Nice. From Bismarck, that area, or smaller town?
So Dickinson is towards the western part of the state.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up north of Belfield, which is about 18 miles west of Dickinson. So I grew up like 40 miles from the Montana border. So northwest part of North Dakota, northwest part of the state.
So being from out in that area, were you a shooter? Like, did you shoot in real life?
Did you
go hunting?
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Do you still do that to this day?
No, I haven't for a while.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, I just, gaming kind of took over my life.
No, the reason I was asking, man, because I was curious to know if, like, you were, like, a shooter in real life or a hunter.
Oh, yeah.
Whether or not that helped you to become such a good shot in video gaming.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, because, I mean, really, the way I personally think about it is, like, gaming, you're operating. You know, you're the one that's controlling the character. You're the one that's making the plays. So, like, I grew up, you know, running equipment. You know, I grew up on a farm, you know, driving tractors, mm-hmm. and shooting guns, working on stuff. So what I'm getting to is it's your motor skills, and that's why I was talking about reaction times earlier.
Yeah.
You know, it's really all just your motor skills. So, yeah, I feel like shooting and that concentration and, you know, holding the gun steady to make the shot, you know, pulling the trigger slowly, and just it all comes together and to just your, you know, your mechanical skills. That's the way I think of it, though. You know, someone might think differently, but that's just me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even like there's you know, I know some guys that are really good at basketball and they're very good gamers. You know, it's your hand eye coordination.
Yeah.
It has to do with you know, your brain.
Now, do you think that younger gamers, because I had this conversation with some comp players, right?
Yeah.
And we were saying that, or the topic, what we were talking about was that younger players have an advantage over older players, right? Because of that reaction time, that hand-eye coordination that they got. And
yeah.
So the theory was that dudes that are like, or gals that are like in their teens or even their early 20s, they've just got way better hand-eye coordination, you know, and are able to be more accurate players. Do you think that's true?
I agree with some of it,
mm-hmm.
but, you know, there is guys my age,
mm-hmm.
that, you know, are still, like, pros, you know, on YouTube and stuff, and, you know, they're making money gaming. And I think a lot of it has to just do, like I said, with yourself, you know, with stress in your life. You get older, you become an adult, shit happens. So, I mean, it really, it kind of just depends how your life is going, too. I mean, if you got a lot of shit on your mind, like me, I'm not nearly as good as I used to be. And, like, when I was, like, 12 years old, oh, my God. My reaction times were, like, godlike, you know. And, yeah, I agree with that 100%.
Yeah.
But, yeah, some of these young kids. So what I'm getting to, what I'm saying is, yeah, of course. They, you know, they're going to school. They're at home yet. They have no idea, no sense of reality, no stress. They're just all freaking juiced up, you know, on life and, you know, freaking gonna go play some games, and I get that, but yeah, you know, it is true. But you know, if a person could figure out a way to control their stress or whatever, and you know, not worry and just be a kid again, then you can get back to that, is what I'm saying.
You can get back
to that state of mind, and that's what I'm striving for. I've been getting a little better about it.
So let me ask you another question then. It's kind of on this subject. Is gaming a form of relaxation for you?
You know, no, it never has. It's always been like a satisfying thing for me. Like, you know, the satisfaction of achieving something that I'm thinking about. Like, that's why I have all those, you know, montages and stuff, you know, because I like the thrill of going for something different and really cool.
Yeah.
You know, it's not relaxing for me. I get so fucking wound up that I'm surprised that I haven't just had a heart attack.
This is how I know my peeper hurts, man. These are the two, like ideas, right? When I think of you, I think of two things. I think of a very skilled sniper, right? A guy who can one-shot people, right? With the DLT 19X, the Pulse, the Cycler, on and on, right? Any of these super skillful guns, right? So I think of you as one of the Pulse and sniper gods, right, in this game. The other thing that I think about you is a guy who's into his craft, you know? Like, you don't just use sniper loadouts, man. You use all kinds of loadouts. Okay.
Yeah.
And you know, you've got thousands. What do you got? Like 600,000 kills, bro. And you have the same amount of hours in this game as me. You know. And I don't think I'm even close to 300,000 yet. Okay. You've just really perfected the art of killing people in this game, killing players. Okay. So when you got into this game, did you come into this game 5 years ago? Did you come into this game with that mindset to be a sniping god, or, you know, somebody who's honing in on his craft? Tell us your early history.
My early history when I first got, I don't know, lost for words, you know, how could you say, you know, fantasized about it. It's like, oh wow, like okay, here. So what I realized was that you can get good gameplays using almost anything in this game. You know, I realized that you can use the bounty hunter combo for almost so many different varieties of loadouts and get these amazing gameplays and kill streaks. And you know, I never came in and thought, oh, just pulse cannon, just this, just that. So eventually throughout the years, I have like four main loadouts. You know, the first was, you know, the bounty hunter pulse cannon, you know, and then the second, which I realized, which is super good with bounty hunter, that a lot of people don't use, but you have to kind of be on fire. You got to be on your toes doing well.
Yeah.
Is you use jetpack, explosive shot, and back the bomb. And
right.
Once you hit trait 3, you can just stay active in the air, and you can just keep shooting people from the sky, and it's really overpowered. And then I always liked the triple loadout. So, you know, I do the cycler and the cooling cell and pulse cannon, and that's my triple snipe. But the other really good one, which is the fourth, is I really like triple health. So you use Medroid, Adrenaline, and Bacta with Bodyguard and triple health. So when I came into this game, I didn't have no idea. I never even thought what you were saying. That never crossed my mind. Like, oh, I'm going to stick to this one thing and be a stupid, you know, piece of shit like Special Needs and some of these other guys like Subsided and come on here every day drooling through my mouth with an E3 and Bodyguard, you know. I never thought of that. What I was always thinking was just like, oh, I wonder if I can use this or that. So, for instance, I used to have a loadout for every map for each side. So, like, on Sero Sub, one thing that's hilarious to do, because there's so many flat surfaces, there's those crates and everything everywhere, right?
Yeah.
So, on Sero Sub, if you use Bounty Hunter, Shield, and Laser Trip Mine, and you hit Trait 3, you will about crack your ribs from laughing if you jump around and you place a Trip Mine on one of those flat walls and bait a guy to run around and blow up into it.
Yeah.
And then, like, on Forest Moon of Endor,
yeah,
that is the best map to run the scout class on. You know, it's like, I realize on this game, you know, I never thought, oh, just this loadout, just that, you know, stick to this and that, you know, again, repeating myself. But, no, I realized that it's like, hey, you know, they kind of made this game to where there's an option for almost everything.
Yeah.
And there really is. You know, that's one thing for sure, is that Forest Moon of Endor is awesome for scout. You know, I've got some really good scout games there.
Right.
And Graveyard of Giants, it goes both ways with Berserker and Bodyguard and stuff. I still haven't found a good strat for Escape Artist, but
Oh, I got one.
What?
I use Escape Artist with my bow. I use bow and disruption with
oh, okay.
And so what I do is I jump back in, I disrupt, and I can outrun the player that's, you know, disrupted and kill him with the bow.
Oh,
but
okay.
That's about it. That's all I can do with it.
Yeah.
So yeah, maybe you're right. There isn't really a good strat for it. It works sometimes for me.
I never, when I came into this game, I never thought, yeah, I'm just going to stick with this one thing. You know, my mind, till this day, 5 years later, I'm still trying to think of different things, you know, I can do.
Right.
You know, even like using Krennic's pistol with explosive shot, you know, just going for A180, you know, Jin's pistol. You know, gameplays, yeah. And upload it. And that's how I came across Triple Snipe. You know, mm-hmm. It's like, oh, you know, I wonder if I can do this and that and that. And, you know, I'm still thinking of things. Oh, one that I like to do on Survivors of Endor, mm-hmm. is to use triple explosive. So mm-hmm. you use thermal detonator, explosive shot, and barrage with Bounty Hunter. You can tell that Bounty Hunter is my favorite.
Yeah.
And yeah, you know, I've gotten like 50 kills using that, and a lot of my friends, they'll even say, you know, I can't really say this myself, it just doesn't sound good, but they have, you know, they've always said I can use pretty much almost any loadout and get 50 kills, and I really can. I mean, you can damn near name something off, and I can get 50 with it, mm-hmm. and that's something that's really cool.
Okay,
and
let's talk about Battlefront early on, bro. Some of your memories, okay? For example, right? Let's talk about the patches, okay? Let's talk about how the roles used to be, okay?
Oh, yeah.
That kind of stuff, okay? For the players who came into this game not in 2016, 2015 like us, okay, but came on later, right? Tell them some of the changes that have occurred.
When this game first came out, there was no role in it. I remember Star Wars HQ, if you look up that channel, I don't know if they have a playlist or not, but they have like 800,000 subscribers.
Yeah.
And, you know, they did all the patch notes for this game, you know, hey, this is what they're doing now, and
yeah.
This week and that week, and I always remember watching them and keeping up to date with it when this game was in its prime. And for the longest time, I think it was like maybe 3 months in or even longer, there was no role in this game.
Yeah.
And I remember when they introduced the role, and that was such a big thing. There's a lot of hype for that because it was so weird. playing a Battlefront that didn't have a role in it. Another thing was, if you notice now, your character, they will, when you're running or just fighting in general, they will look side to side, and their head will move, and they have more, just more movement in general, and that was something that was added in. Otherwise, before, it was really, I don't know, just weird, strange looking. Your character was just looking, you know, straight ahead.
Yeah.
And it was just awkward, you could say.
Oh, I think I lost you, bro.
No, Rabid was talking to me. He said, okay. He said, hi. He said, tell Labyrinth. Rabid says hi.
Okay, right on.
If he's still making any new friends.
Holy shit.
Any new friends?
You're with Rabid right now, bro?
Yeah, I'm at his house.
I didn't realize that you actually meet players, bro.
Yeah.
Is this the first time you guys met?
Yeah, Labyrinth knows. I'm always...
Yeah, Yep.
Nice, dude. How you doing, Rabbit?
Oh, I met Vooman.
Vooman 2.
Vooman, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, he's a buddy of mine. Nice,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, I met him.
He came out.
I actually went and picked him up from the airport.
Mm-hmm. How you doing, Rabbit? Can you hear me?
No.
Oh, okay. Right on.
I remember when they changed Leia's honor guards. So the coolest thing was Leia's original honor guards. They used to have A280Cs.
Yeah.
And they were ridiculous. They were better than the heroes at that time. Almost better than every hero that was in the game. And I think that's why they took them out and put the ones with the DH-17s in. And I mean, I used to get like 40 kill streaks with them.
Oh yeah, they were OP, bro, back in the day.
Yeah.
They're still OP though, with that DH-17.
And there used to be a glitch in this game with the back-to-bomb, to where when they first brought the back-to-bomb in, I swear it almost took them a year to fix it until it was like recognized and known until word got out. But you could throw the back-to-bomb on the ground, and you could just sit there and stand in that pool, that blue mist that's kind of floating in the air, and it would keep healing you, and you could just sit there and shoot people.
Yeah, man, there was all kinds of glitches early on in the game. Probably the most famous glitch was the Lando power blast glitch.
Yeah. Yeah.
Did you ever use them?
No.
Did you use them early on?
Yeah. Handicap.
You just go full explosive shot without a cool, without a heat, overheat.
Yeah.
Yep, absolutely.
And only shot used to be OP.
Yeah, one thing, the way the traits were, Berserker used to be like bodyguard. Berserker was a really strange card. It was a weird trait. Mm-hmm. It was 70, it was 50%, it was like 75 or 50% damage reduction and then 50% blaster increase. But you had to lose like 30 health to get the blaster buff. You had to get shot. You had to let someone shoot you.
Yeah.
And that was really weird. And I remember when they first changed all of the traits, and I was really pissed when they ruined Bounty Hunter. Because, oh my god, the clips I could achieve with the original Bounty Hunter right now would be freaking godly. I remember the original Bounty Hunter was so overpowered because guys would just... They would use Jetpack, Shield, and the Bowcaster. And they would just jump around and just kill after kill, an instant card refresh.
Bro,
instant.
I used to do that particular loadout because back in the day when you leveled up on that Bounty Hunter with the Bowcaster, right, and you're jetpacking every, 2 seconds? The Bowcaster actually had more damage. It had explosive, like an explosive shot effect, you know, like what Chewie's, it had like this big
splash
effect.
Damage.
Yep. Exactly. Yeah. And
you
it was
just shoot near them.
Yep, you didn't have to land it on them. And I used to use that a lot, man. If I could, you know, level up, I would try to do it.
So, say you hit trade 3 Bounty Hunter right now, how fast your cards refresh. So, even if you didn't get the kill back then, which gave you the instant refresh, they would still cool down as fast as they do right now. So it was like double overpowered. And bodyguard used to just be explosive resistance. That's why like no one used it. God, I don't think anyone ever used bodyguard.
Mm-hmm.
It used to just be explosive resistance. And then of course I think everyone knows about the one hit melee that escape artists used to have.
Mm-hmm.
That was actually pretty cool. But yeah, they changed that about a couple weeks and they're like, yeah, maybe no, maybe not.
Bro, let me tell you the only time that I ever went on YouTube to watch a tutorial, right, about something on Battlefront. It was when the roll first came out, and I saw players rolling forward, not side to side, but forward, you know, doing the barrel roll. And I never understood how to do it, right? I couldn't get it. And so it was the only time I went on YouTube to see someone's vid, his tutorial about how to roll forward. It's real complicated, right? I've got the roll. I don't have it on the R3. You have it on the R3, right? Your roll?
Yeah, I use a right analog stick.
Yeah, so I use, you know, the default, the circle. And you have to tap it twice, right? You have to tap it twice to roll left or right. Okay, well, to go forward, right, you have to run. Hold
look
on.
Look to the side.
Yeah, you gotta run, look to the side, and then jump out of it, right? Oh, shit, I'm trying to do it right.
You don't have to jump,
about this
but
roll.
That's just how you get your speed. That's just how you get your speed boost.
Watch, spawn on me if you can. Spawn on me.
No, I'm Palpatine.
Oh. Okay, I'm over here doing, practicing barrel rolls.
Fuck you, Chicos, and your stupid piece of shit E4.
Bro, there was a time when I got calluses. I played so much. I got calluses on my fingers from rolling, from moving around, from pressing down on the L3, you know, the analog, the left analog, constantly running. Those calluses have gone away, bro. It's been a few years.
Oh yeah, I believe you.
Played this game so much, bro. I've got like 3,000 hours on this game. you were playing this game, right? You were trying out different loadouts. You were trying out different trades, different cards. How would you describe your game style, man, after all these years of playing?
Well, basically, how I would describe myself is all around. I mean, I can do objective. I've never been solely objective. I've always been kind of, you know, more focusing on game plays, you know, trying to get, you know, like the... I've always wanted to do like 100+ with the night sniper and sharpshooter and stuff like that. So I mean, my game style, I don't know how to define it, because it's kind of all over. I'm always doing something different, but for the most part, I'm always aggressive. You know, even with triple snipe, with no heals, no shields, I'm always a very aggressive player. Because I feel like when you play aggressive, you're more accurate, you're trying harder, the aggression. So, I don't know, my game style is, I would say, aggressive.
Well, they say, you know, the best defense is a good offense. You know, that's always been my mentality in this game. You know, personally, I'm known as an aggressive player. People think I'm a suicider. I'm not a suicider. I just play very aggressively, but I understand what you're talking about. We got to talk about your stats here real quick, okay? Because I don't know if you have Battlefront Companion right now, and you're able to look.
I can, if you want.
Yeah. Let's look at your stats here.
So, and I like comparing them to guys, some of these other guys. Like, I don't know if are you friends with like Shame Dead?
I know of him. I'm not friends with him. And I probably teabag him if I see him in the game.
So, like, Shame, his stats are insane, but he has, like, 5,000 hours.
Yeah.
So he has, like, 700 and, like, he has, like, 720,000 kills, and he has, like, 17,000 Walker Salt wins, which is insane.
Yeah.
But, for the amount of hours, so for me, I have 2,982 hours as we speak.
Right.
And I have 624,000 kills. So I have, you know, almost half the hours as some of these other guys and
right.
just as many kills. So one thing I want to throw in real quick is that my account got banned so many times that I was forced to play on my other account, which is just regular OG Peeps, and I have like 30,000-40,000 kills on that account. So technically, you know, I have about 700,000 kills on about 3,000 hours. And anyway,
damn,
so
bro.
looking at the app, 624,000 kills on this account, 2,900 hours. I have 165,000 assists. I have 150,000 deaths. I have 2,842 suicides, 11,000 wins, 5,000 losses. I have 8 draws. Those are rare to come by.
Yeah.
18,000 vehicles destroyed, 246,075,000 score. I have 371 Briar pistol kills. I have 11,731 DH-17 kills, 1,971 DL-18 kills, 1,800 DL-44, 7,000 DT-12, 3,900 A-180, 4,000 with Krennic's pistol, the DT-29, 2,700 with the SE-14C. I have 4,000 with the Night Sniper. I have 54,000 with the A280C, 13,000 with the E11, 91,000 with the E3, 44,000 with the E4, 39,000 with the DLT-19, 22,000 with the heavy repeater, and only 93 with the piece of shit RT-97C. And
fucking noob.
4,000. I cannot. I hate the way that gun looks. It just looks disgusting. It sounds disgusting, and it just shoots like shit. And 4,000 with the T-21. And this one I really like. I just shy of 12,000. I have 11,877 with the CA-87, the shotgun.
Mm-hmm.
And I got 1,300 with the bow rifle, 35,936 with the DLT-19X. Just shy of 6,000 with the Ralby by 35. 1,900 with the T21B. Game modes, got 62 cargo wins, 5,000 supremacy, 63 sabotage, only 4,800 walker, 184 blasts, 69 droid run, 69 turning point, only 11 fighter squadron, 21 drop zone. I never play none of these small modes. I just skip over these. I got 457 hero hunt wins. Skip over a lot of this that don't really matter. So the main cards I use, I got 3,600 with the scattergun, 43,000 with the pulse, and 4,200 with the cycler. Don't got very many ship kills. I rarely in vehicles. And with Bossk, I got 52,000 with Vader, 8,600, 3,900 with Dengar, 4,700 with Greedo, 1,600 with Krennic, 22,000 with Palpatine. No, with Bulba, 22,000 with Bulba, 7,200 with Palpatine. 4,500 with Chewbacca, 3,200 with Han, 2,000 with Jin, 13,000 with Lando. This is kind of dragging
okay,
on.
Okay, we got it. 20,000. We got it, bro. Yeah. You got a lot of kills. Yeah. Okay, listen. So, yes, you got massive amount of kills with all of the weapons, just about all of the weapons, okay? This is like Exhibit A for the argument that you are a player that's focused on developing your skill, you know? Or I just shouldn't say developing.
I say challenging yourself.
Challenging yourself. There you go. You know, a lot of players, like myself, I include myself, I stay with the same loadout, dude, year after year. I stay with the same gun year after year. And for me, I'm not focused on challenging myself in that regard, in that way. I challenge myself in other ways, right? One of the ways I challenge myself is by facing off against parties, facing off against tryharders alone.
Yeah,
And so that's what I'm known for. I face off against parties in my mode supremacy with just my partner about 90% of the time, and so that for me is the challenge, right? Is how to win games under those circumstances. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but no, I agree, that's quite the challenge.
But when I see players like yourself, right, who have been able to master so many different weapons, so many different loadouts, my hat's off to players like yourself. All right, we're going to move on now to the next subject, what I really know you as, right? A pulse god. Tell us the story, dude, of how you became so proficient with this gun. As you saw in our 1v1, I just got lucky a couple of times, bro, against you, okay? I didn't spend a lot of time playing with this gun. And as you see here in this gameplay, I'm sucking ass, dude, big time with the DLT 19X. So tell us how you developed this skill, dude, to use this gun that I think is fucking trash, bro. I hate the pulse. Okay, it doesn't fire, it doesn't land where I put the fucking reticle on. I mean, there's all kinds of issues with the gun, in my opinion, you know. But everybody's different. So tell us the story.
So I would say basically it stems back to every other game I've played. I've always been a sniper, you know, and whether it's Call of Duty, Battlefield, whatever it was, I've always been addicted to the one shot because they're very, very high risk, but very high reward. So it rewards, you know, the skill, the, how could you say, the intensity of, you know, lining it up, making that shot hit. So it's very high risk, high reward.
Yeah.
And it's just always been a passion, you know, and it goes for any game that I play in the future too. If there's a sniper, I'm gonna be using it. So it's kind of as simple as that, really.
Yeah.
Is kind of a sucky, you know, kind of shitty answer for doing this, you know, interview, but it's really that, you know, that simple. It's just I've always been a sniper. Mm-hmm. And it's just hilarious too when you kill some, you know, try hard using an E3 with the 19X or the cycler. It's like, you know.
that's what I did to special needs in those earlier matches, bro. I managed to pull some at close range too. So he must have been hating life at that moment. Hey, but let me ask you a question on what you just said right now. So, you know, when I first started to game, I told you I played Battlefield, right? And yeah. I also sniped in that game. This is why I have low sensitivity. I play with low sensitivity. I play with 9 sensitivity, right? And everybody always is like tripping about the fact that I play with such low sensitivity. But I started to play with low sensitivity because I was sniping in this game called Battlefield. And you just have so much more control, man. Looking down the sights, right, with lower sensitivity. And so I just took my comfort and my just being accustomed to playing with low sensitivity into this game, where I didn't, unlike in Battlefield, develop into another sniper with the pulse and what have you. But I took that low sensitivity into my aggressive style of play, right? Do you play with low sensitivity, or what's your sensitivity, bro?
I play on 75, and every other game I've ever played on, Like on Call of Duty, I always played on insane. So when you'd max out the sensitivity, it just said insane.
Yeah.
So I would always play on insane sensitivity.
Right.
And the main reason, you know, if you have that competitive spirit and gaming,
yeah.
You need the high sensitivity to move and look and react as quick as you can. And so, like, right. You with the 9 sensitivity, what I always say is, you know, there is not no one meta fits all. And, you know, use this, it's the best, blah, blah, blah. I hate those conversations. It's all yeah. a bunch of shit. So what I'm right. saying and getting to is, it's whatever works for you. Everyone's like, oh, what should I use? What should I do? And, you know, the horrible answer that you give them, which is actually the right and the correct one, because they don't know, is you got to figure it out for yourself, what works best for you. It's right. like, I can't tell you, because everyone's different. And, you know, if your 9 works for you, that's what works for you.
Right.
So, yeah, you know, you might get, you know, other gamers, you know. But, you know, it's just what works for you. And
so when you started to snipe in Battlefront, okay, did you start with the Pulse, the DLT-19X, the Cycler?
No, the Pulse.
Okay. What'd you like about it? And
oh,
why did you stick with it?
The one shot. The uh-huh. one shot, and I love the way that it sounds, you know, like when
yeah.
you're charging it. And it
right.
just, it sounds... Yeah, it's mainly just the way that it feels.
So did you have a hard time with it early on trying to
no,
understand
no,
it?
I took straight to it.
Oh, right on.
Oh yeah,
unlike me, I still haven't taken to it.
Yeah, you can see I if you look up the timestamp when this game came out, the very first montage I uploaded was like, I don't think it was even 3 months into the game, and I was using the Pulse then, like, pretty much like I am now.
Yeah.
I mean, I took straight to it, because that's what I was saying, like, even if this game wasn't Battlefront, it wasn't called Battlefront, I understood the movement, how it worked, and I just, yeah, I was just like, okay, I got
right.
this.
All right, so, tell us about your greatest duels. Tell us about the players, the other snipers in this game that you've come across over these last 5 years that you've had your greatest battles against.
Number one, probably one of the best. It's a hard toss-up. Rip Rogers and Kevin's Base, they are freaking amazing 19X players, and it's hard to say that one's better than the other. Mm-hmm. I think they're so freaking close, but those are probably the best 19X players in this game. I mean, they're crazy. Like, I'm friends with Rip Rogers, mm-hmm. and he has like 70,000 kills with the 19X. It's mm-hmm. insane.
Nice.
You know, it's crazy. I'm not friends with Kevin's Base, but yeah, he I mean, I've been in multiple games with him, and he'll go like 40-0 regularly with the 19X. I don't even do that.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just super good with it. And
right.
so, I mean, those are my greatest sniper duels with the 19X. Kind of regrettingly saying this, it really pisses me off. He's annoying little shit, Arthur Koss. He's good with the 19X, but he mains just Bounty Hunter and Secondary Fire, and it's really annoying. But he's hit me with some really nice freaking 19X shots that are pretty damn good.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I've had some good duels with him, those three. There's this one player, see if you recognize the name, that I used to just cuss. This is about the first year or two into the game, talking about greatest duels. So there's three so far. There's Rip Rogers, Kevin's Base, and Arthur Koss with the 19X.
Mm-hmm.
So as far as Pulse Cannon, someone that used to really piss me off, let's see if you catch on to this. His name was Waynick, and... Oh my god, do you know who that is?
Yeah, 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 I've seen the guy before. I don't know him, but I've seen
him. Do you
know
who Waynick is?
I've seen the name, but, you know, I'm not a...
It's way good.
Is it?
It's way good,
okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Wainik is Wake's original name.
Okay.
This is before like we even knew of each other. You know, this was when the game was still fresh. But God, I remember like the first time he killed me, and we talk about it all the time and laugh, was on Junlin Waste. You know, he jump pulsed me, and my ego, you know, oh my God, you know, how dare you not just stand still and let me kill you, you know. He jump pulsed me, and I would just call him every word under the sun, you know, you stupid effing piece of shit, and blah, blah, blah. Oh my God, I used to get so pissed off. But it turned into something a lot better. But yeah, Pulse Battles with Wainik, that was his original gamer tag, and as you can tell to this day, I still have really good laughs about it. And as another Pulse player, I don't even know. At this point, I'd just be guessing if I thought of someone, but there's a lot of people that are good with the Pulse, but I'd say people that truly mastered it would be like, you know, way good me, and I don't know, I guess Hella good. She's hit me with some really, really crazy pulse cannon shots. Some that kind of stung and hurt the ego a little bit. So that's worthy of noting. So those would be the two pulse cannon duels for sure. It would be way good and Hella.
Shout out to Hella.
Without a doubt.
Okay, what about your cycler? Top five. That's a different gun altogether.
Oh, God, what's his name? Damn, I can't remember his name. He still plays right now. Lax Kid. He uses T21B and the Cycler rifle. Mm-hmm. And I got to respect it because it is skill. And he just lines up the shots and he'll headshot you. And he's freaking good with the Cycler. I actually, you know, is kind of annoying, pisses me off, but that is such a hard gun to use that you gotta respect it.
That gun, dude, it's got like tremendous drop at distance, right? You have to lead it differently, on and on. Tell us some of the differences between the Cycler, the DLT 19X, and the Pulse. How do you use them differently?
Well, the Cycler is amazing. If I always say you have to, for me anyway, you have to be on fire. You have to already be playing really well. You know, you're hitting all your shots already.
Yeah.
But the Cycler, I mean, I can't even find a way to describe the precision you can do with it. I mean, like, you could shoot a, if there was a golf ball in this game, how tiny it'd be, you could hit it with the Cycler. You can make the craziest pinpoint shots with it that are just so good. I mean, you can hit almost anything with it if you're trying hard enough.
Yeah.
And that's the cool part. Someone can be in cover and you can still hit them with it. There's just something about it. It's really good for just these tiny little precise shots.
Right.
And the pulse cannon has a lot of splash damage, and it's honestly kind of easy to use once you get the hang of it. Because, I mean, you can hit the side of someone's body, you can hit their foot, you know, and you're going to one-shot them. So, I mean, the pulse cannon, it really doesn't need much explaining.
Yeah.
But, I mean, yeah, because that gun just has a ton of splash.
Wait. Really the good. Pulse, I need an explanation, man, about the pulse. Because I don't know how many times I've lined up a shot on the reticle, okay? And the fucking thing goes, you know, 20 feet to the left or to the right.
You can't move. You can't move.
Okay.
You can't move when you're on the ground. If you step a foot or two to the left, I mean, it's one thing that you just learn to master.
Yeah.
But you can't move. Otherwise, it just veers off. It's weird. You have to be standing perfectly still 98% of the time. I mean, yeah, you can charge it up and sidestep, but then you got to stop. You know, you can't move at all and shoot. And you do have to lead a little bit with it.
So give me two or three really good Cycler users.
Well, Lax Kid, and honestly, not that many people use it, but Rabid Lapdog is really good with the Cycler. He actually... he has the most cycler rifle kills on PlayStation 4, like world record. He has like 20,000 cycler rifle kills. He's probably the best.
Wow.
Yeah, if you went through, if you could somehow friend every person that's ever played Battlefront and look at their stats, mm-hmm. And Rabbit has the most EE3 kills on PS4 in the world. He has like 330,000 EE3 kills. He has like 330,000 EE3 and 20,000 cycler rifle kills. Mm-hmm. So he's number one on cycler. And Lax Kid, just from playing, he's ridiculously good with it. You know, don't stand still if you see him.
Yeah.
And I can't really think of a third, because many, honestly, you don't see anyone use it. I guess the only person I know that uses it like religiously is Red Salute. He uses back to bomb, shield, and cycler. And he's a good cycler player, so those would be my personal three. I mean, someone else out there, you know, maybe watches this, might know someone else, but that's just who I know.
I want you to talk about, you know, why. So what I want to do is I want to synthesize, right, your play style, the fact that you use certain guns, right, that you're known for certain guns, the reason why you try out different loadouts and you hone your craft. Tell us, bring it all together, man. Tell us why you do all of this stuff, right?
I guess the main thing for me is, like, when I started doing YouTube on this, it was like in the prime of this game, and I was hoping to inspire and like show people, like, hey, you know, you can do almost anything in this game and still do good, you know, trying to use all these different loadouts.
Yeah.
But then, you know, as the game progressed and everyone just started using back to guard, it turned into more of an ego thing, to where, like, you know, using triple snipe, now I can, you know, when I'm feeling good, you know, playing well, I average 30 to 50 and sometimes, you know, break up to 80. And to me personally, that's like the ultimate flex, because, you know, It's such a topic now with modders. So it's like, when you drop 30 to 50 kills a game using triple snipe, what are you going to say? People can't say shit to that. So it's like, you know, you got no heals. You have nothing to heal yourself. You have no shields, you know, block incoming damage, whatever. And so to me, it's the ultimate flex, you know. It's kind of like, you know, you kill someone like Facebook moms, special needs, Zappy, you know, all these toxic players with triple snipe, and you do better than them, you know, it's kind of just like saying you're shit, man.
No, I definitely understand this, dude. When I've run into you, when we've been on opposing sides in Supremacy, whenever I've seen you, I don't bum rush you, dude. Like, I bum rush a lot of guys, okay? I have to be more respectful, right, of your skill. I still try to rush you, though.
Oh, yeah.
But that's just my style.
Ooh, of course.
You know? Fuck! Cannot land nothing. Oh, finally. Tell us five players, okay, in all of these 5 years, bro, that have impacted this game positively or negatively in your mind.
Well, positively, stating the obvious, you know, is way good. I mean, what he's done for this game, the promotion he's done for it is, you know, no one has done what he's done. You know, it's amazing, you know, starting that Discord and everything he's done. And he's never been, like, you know, I mean, yeah, he likes his strafing and stuff, and, you know, who doesn't? I like the snow speeder. But yeah, way good. Way good's definitely the first positive. I'd say for a negative, you know, I even told him in the Discord too, DJ Chimera. Yeah. You know, he said, he's like, I only got like 70,000 ship kills or whatever, and I have more blaster kills. You know, that guy, him, and, you know, when he played steadily, and, you know, he still does. I guess he has like 14 accounts, so you never know. You're probably playing against him sometimes. But, you know, it's like, he's the type of player to where I think he's had a negative impact, you know, because of the strafing. And he set a stereotype, and, like, Zappy does the same thing now, you know. So I think that was negative because a lot of people followed that playstyle to where if someone just looks at you, you pop your personal shield, you know?
Yeah.
It's so fucking annoying. And, you know, the strafing and just what got set up there. So I think that's a negative there. God, who'd be another positive? As far as influence or just, you know, games, people that you run into. Mm-hmm. Or more of, I would say a personal positive influence is, one Vasquez. He's a player that I play with, you know, regularly for the past couple of years.
Yeah.
And, I don't know, it's just his spirit, the way he plays. He will go like 0-9 or, you know, 2-10 or, you know, positive or whatever, but
yeah,
he'll always get MVP, and it's just so funny. You know, I'll be all pissed off and, you know, being myself, and he'll be like, oh, I'm feeling it when the game is ending, and he'll be like 0-9 and he'll get the MVP, and it's just funny. I've had so many moments playing with him, and whenever, you know, we switched to the Imperials, he's like, all right, it's time to put my bucket hat on. The other positive experience I've had is good players like Stykel and Darksiders. Those are guys like me. Now, Stykel and Darksiders is someone to be reckoned with. Is someone you don't just fuck with, because they are actually just good players, and they can use any loadout and smack these modders and these other players with just skill. You know, like Stykel. God, the guy can just use anything like I can, and like Darksiders can, and he'll kick your ass. You got to be careful. I don't know if you ever played against Stykel, but
I've seen him whenever I've gone into Walker, I see the guy.
Yeah, he usually plays Walker.
Yeah.
And it's funny because, you know, he has horrible connection and bad leg, and so he's always trying to think of something to, like, make it easier, and he'll do really good with it, you know? Like, he'll use the T21B with sharpshooter and explosive shot and get 50 kills and, like, 50 and 2. But the thing is, he can do the try-hard, you know, back-to-guard loadout and be that guy, too, but... You know, it's just the moral of the story is he had a positive impact for me, and just kind of showing other people, you know, that, you know, yet again, you can use anything in this game and do good. You know, almost anything you use has a huge benefit in this game, the way it's set up. I can't even explain it myself. And like Darksiders, you know, he's made so many videos lately showcasing, you know, different loadouts and stuff. And he's another player you'll come across in Walker Assault. And, you know, the other day I was playing him on Survivors of Endor, and I think he was using Bounty Hunter with Cooling Cell, DH-17, and, like, Flash Grenade. You know, no heals. Mm-hmm. No heals, no shield, and he was doing good. And, you know, those are the people that had a positive impact on me and on other players, because they see what they're using and they see how good they're doing. And that reflects back on me as well, because I've seen other people use my loadouts. You know, like, I'll be doing good. You know, I'll kill these. That's why I said it's so funny killing these tryhards with, like, the triple snipe loadout. You know, they're using back to guard E3 and E4. And I start killing them, and then next thing I know, I see other people using some of the, you know, multiple different loadouts that I'm using. So, yeah. And then these other guys, you know, Stykel and Darksiders, they're doing the same thing, and it's just, those are positive influences, you know, to me anyway.
Okay. You know, the purpose of this question, when I ask my guests to name me five players who've impacted the game, I can't interview everybody, man, on this program. You know what I'm saying? And there's just so many players, man, that have done good things in this game. But, you know, I'm not going to get around to interviewing everybody. And so it's an opportunity for the players that I do interview to, you know, shine some light on these players and get them some recognition for the stuff that they do in this game. What are you interested in, bro, outside of Battlefront? What kind of things you like to do?
Well, I've been playing guitar since I was 7.
Mm-hmm.
So I've always played guitar. I like playing guitar. Pretty good at it.
Electric or acoustic?
Both. I played more acoustic than electric, but mm-hmm. I play both.
What kind of music do you like to play?
A little of everything. Country, rock. Never really stuck to just one genre.
Mm-hmm. Any particular songs you like to play?
Yeah, I like to play. I can play about the first quarter of Enter the Sandman.
Oh, yeah?
And, I can play some AC/DC, like Hell's Bells.
Mm-hmm.
I like We're From the Country by Tracy Byrd, playing that on the guitar. It's really cool. One thing I learned about, you know, music is a lot of people listen to songs and they don't like them, but when you're a player and you start, you know, you realize that these tunes, how cool they are, that they really made, when you're playing them, it puts a whole new perspective on it.
Right.
So a lot of these songs that people don't like, if they could actually play them in real life, in reality, they would understand it a totally different way. Another interest is I grew up riding, you know, dirt bike and four-wheelers and stuff, so I've got my own YZ250F, so I got some motorhead in me. I'm a motorhead. I like horsepower. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I like horsepower. I got a old Chevy pickup, not old, but a 1984 square body Chevy. You know, you're familiar, really popular square bodies. I get a square body I've been restoring. Outside of Battlefront, I'd say other games. I'm a huge gamer. Like I said, I grew up playing the Sega on up through Game Boy, through Nintendo, PS2, 3, 4, getting to 5. And so, I mean, outside of Battlefront would be other games, you know, because I'm just a huge gamer.
What are you playing these days besides Battlefront?
I really like Save the World on Fortnite. So it's the mode that the game was originally built and intended for. They were never going to put the Battle Royale into Fortnite. It was kind of added at the last minute. So the zombies mode, the Save the World on Fortnite is a mode that I play a lot. So like earlier when I was talking about on PS3 how I had my just play a video game, have fun, was zombies on Black Ops, and then I played MW3 for my multiplayer, you know, satisfaction, my thrill.
Yeah.
And on next gen, on PlayStation 4, my multiplayer, you know, adrenaline fix is Battlefront, and my chill, I'm just gonna have fun, you know, is Save the World.
Mm-hmm.
So that's my teeter-totter, my back and forth. So Save the World and Batman Arkham Knight is a freaking amazing game. I love playing that. I actually got the Platinum Trophy on there, and I sent Ark Wayne a message. If he watches this, he still needs to change his gamer tag because I am the Batman, and there can only be one, and I got the Platinum Trophy. So he still has to change his gamer tag. Outside of Battlefront, I don't really like much else. I'm a good cook. I like cooking. I can do some pretty good cooking. I like making good food for myself. Pretty simple person. But
what do you like to cook?
Yeah. Oh, I can cook some pretty good steaks.
Nice.
Good steaks, good meals, potatoes. Just normal, basic meals, but make them good, you know, and do a good job on them.
Do you smoke or grill?
Oh, I used to.
No, I don't mean smoke weed, bro. Smoke your meats.
Yeah, well, I mean, if a Traeger grill counts, the pellet grills, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Right on, bro.
To that one real quick.
Hey, man, listen, I appreciate you coming on Tales of Battlefront, man. It's so awesome to have you and to hear these stories. And, you know, you're such a big part of the PS4 history of this game, bro, with with your pulsing and your everything that you do, man. Appreciate you coming here and telling everybody a little bit more about yourself. That's what this whole show's about, man, is to reveal just a little bit more about the person behind the PSN. I hope you get My Peeper Hurts back.
No, that's what I'm on forever.
Oh, that sucks.
You can't
bro.
Get it back.
Damn.
So, a couple parts I gotta add in real quick.
Sure.
Because it is true. Make sure you get this audio in there. There's couple things. For one, that's unrecognized. When this game came out, Albert Ross uploaded a video on Hoth. He said like 200 kills with Boba Fett. And it had like a couple hundred thousand views, and it was 100 kills per game. He spaced it out between two games, but a lot of people don't know this, and it's unrecognized. I'm a very unrecognized player. I can't find another kill streak, so I hold the Boba Fett world record on PlayStation 4. Now I don't know if someone's got it higher on Xbox, but I haven't seen anything on YouTube. So anyway, I have uploaded proof. I got 149-0 with Boba Fett, and that's a world record, and it's only got like 80 some views, and it's legit. So
hey,
now if
let everybody wait, let everybody know before anything, let everybody know your YouTube channel name. What is it?
It's all capital letters, so it's my gamer tag. It's OG-PEEPS-YT.
All right.
So that's my YouTube, and I do hold the Boba Fett world record. And if someone like Ikeed or Subsided ever breaks that, and to me is a legit gamer, that doesn't count, because I know they're using Cronus and they're hacking and cheating dog shit bullshit. It doesn't fucking count. It doesn't. If someone has a world record and they're using mods and cheating, it doesn't count. But yeah, so I do hold that world record, and get this audio in there. I have 15 montages. Check out all the montages. I take a lot of pride in my solo 200 plus boss kill streaks, because I have no help from my teammates, no callouts, no one giving me BACTA. I went 247-0 solo. That's a big flex for me. So, you know, you got all these other sweaty competitive guys talking shit. It's like, okay, go 247-0. I was talking to Mad Mardigan about that. Next thing I know, he's saying it's so easy. Next thing I know, I see him in a Walker lobby going 150-0 with boss. Yeah, come on, get that extra 60-70. Come on, it's so easy. You know, do it solo. You know.
Right on, but, bro. Yeah, we'll get that
my
in.
Boba Fett world record is unrecognized.